frigid mountains climb towards the skies. As she approached the frozen peaks, lying empty and deserted. She knew great treasures would lie within, but perhaps great horrors too. The mine had been abandoned for some time. No fires burned in the furnaces. No chatter bounced from the rocky walls. All was still. She crept cautiously through the gloom. Crystals bloomed into life at her touch, their light revealing a path.
Not right. Think. Think.
These crystals held a strange resonance. Seams of rich minerals were buried in the walls. She wasn't here for material wealth. She wondered, who had worked these tracks? Who had dug out these walls? What great wonders had begun in this mine? What horrors? Thank you. light from the crystal inspired her. Here was the treasure she truly sought. Even the lifeless rock of the mine couldn't stop the corruption planting its rancid roots, though all was not lost yet. The mine had been built for industry. But she had her own power. Her own means to wealth. If she only had the courage to wield it. Let's go. The crystal crackled with imagination's light, an electrical storm which granted new freedoms. She felt the mind begin to come alive. She found the path, even in darkness. For she had been here before. She was not afraid of the shadows. Machines loomed from the dark. I can hear the machines. They sing to me. They hum to me. She did not need the aid of machines. Thank you. The crystal's glow made everything clear to her. She needed the light that shone from within. The room grew slowly brighter. The factory was the heart of everything. It lay silent now. But it would have to be ready soon. She was running out of time. Where does the time go? I'll never be ready. She entered a cavern, entombed in darkness. It came from the bare rocks. Doubts, fears, insidious ugliness. But she trusted the light she wore. and this mine would survive the shadow. The mine glowed behind her.